Well, hello kids, Dad is back with another video, and if you hear little grunts, squeaks, or little yips in the background, it's just my little man sleeping in the bassinet next to me while I record this video. Now, I know I've been very quiet on this subject recently, and this is more along the lines of what's going on with the Epic Games Store, and also what is happening with a lot of publishers deciding to either not publish their games onto Steam and move it over to the Epic Games Store, or in fact even pull from Steam completely and move it to Epic Games Store instead. Now, a lot of people are claiming things about like, oh, this is competition in the PC space. And to some point, I agree. On the other hand though, this really isn't competition. This is merely Epic Games Store trying to give a better cut for publishers in order to stay on the Epic Games Store front. Epic Games Store has not competed for anyone else in terms of what they're providing to their consumers. They're not competing for the customer, and they're not competing in any other way besides trying to attack the pockets of publishers or developers directly. So because of this, a lot of people are misconstruing what is actual competition in the sense of just using their name and their weight and also trying to undercut Steam in any way they can in order to push their store forward. Will this in turn do anything for the consumer? Probably not. I do want to at least keep an idea of what's been happening, what's been going on, sort of give my whole take on this entire thing. Because of Metro Exodus being cut away from Steam very close to its release, and in fact being on Steam for pre-order for the last 6 months, this is a little bit of a shock, because what you have is a publisher that has worked with Steam in the past, has decided to put their game on Steam, and lo and behold, a few months before release, like I said before, they're going to cut Metro Exodus, delist the game, and only place it on the Epic Games Store for purchase. Now here's the thing with that, right? They are still letting people who pre-ordered the game on Steam still have access to it, still download it, and still play it. And the more we look into what's been going on, we find out that after sometime in February of 2020, the game will then go back to being on Steam, to being available for everyone else to buy on that storefront. Here's my entire crux of this whole thing. The idea of putting a restriction on a storefront for a game is ludicrous. And the reason why I say that is because what makes the PC so fantastic is that it's an open platform. I should be able to choose where I purchase my products. That decision shouldn't be made for me. So if I either want to go to the Epic Games Store and buy a game there, or I want to go to Steam and buy the same game there, it shouldn't really make the difference. What I'm seeing happening is that Epic is putting restrictions on where the publisher can place their game for a specific set amount of time to get that decrease in the cut that Epic would normally take, or that Steam would normally take. That's what it's looking like to me. Because of what's happening with Metro, it looks like, now I can't prove this, but what I'm seeing is that what it looks like is because they're going to put the game back on Steam at some point in the future in 2020, that it seems to be sort of like a timed exclusive to a storefront. And if that sounds ridiculous to you, that's because it is. Now, if we want to take a look at competition and what the Epic Game Store is providing compared to Steam, here's a great little graphic that Soul King Lives on Twitter provided for me. We can just take a look and we can already see that Epic Game Store is really not competing in any way directly with Steam. They're merely throwing their name around as Epic, who are the Fortnite people, and providing publishers with a better cut of the profits, which is honestly a pretty big risk. Because we don't know if Epic Game Store is going to be viable in the future. Many people just see that store as the Fortnite launcher. And to be honest, the Epic Game Store is pretty bare bones. Epic Game Store doesn't have cloud saves, user profiles, user reviews, forums, mod distribution. They do, however, have friends list and a chat app. They don't have groups, they don't have item trading, they don't have library sorting, no account sharing, no streaming to other devices, no broadcasting, no screenshots or sharing, no user-created guides, and no wish lists. So when people say things like, finally someone is competing with Steam, there really is no competition with Steam. Steam is doing a lot for its consumers. Now, they may not be doing a lot for the publishers, but they're definitely doing a lot for people that use the storefront and buy their games there. That's why people get so upset when games aren't on Steam, because we have all these other things that come with this storefront that are so part of this ecosystem that honestly, when you make a storefront like this, you need to be already on par with Steam. Everything that Steam offers, you should already be doing out of the gate. Especially a company as big as Epic, and especially a company that has as much money as Epic does. Cutting down the cost for publishers in something like 88-12, or I don't really remember the actual percentage, but something along those lines of giving the publisher more money, that's great for a smaller developer. Absolutely. Indie guys, 100%. Bigger guys, sure, too. Maybe if they want to do like a mid-budget game or something, that'd be great to see some return. But all they're really doing, all that Epic is actually doing, is just providing a better cut. They're not doing anything else. And in fact, people had to complain to Epic to finally get refunds on that storefront, because their additional refund policy never really made any sense and really honestly wasn't worth it to the consumer. So this is the whole crux of the situation. You've got a game that was on Steam for pre-order for 6 months, was then pulled from Steam to then go exclusively on the Epic storefront because of a better cut for the publisher. And I know what's gonna happen in the comments section. I'm gonna hear everything from, Alex, you're one of those Steam-only people. No, that's not the case at all. See, to me, it really doesn't matter where I buy my games from, because Steam has a really great option of this thing called add a non-Steam game to your library, where I've added everything from emulated games to games I bought from GOG to anything from anywhere, even games I play on Battle.net. So where I buy my game doesn't really matter, and if I'm really worried about how long the game's going to be there, well, there are ways on the PC where you can always have access to something, and if you're savvy enough, you can really get around a lot of, you know, little ways here and there. But that's besides the point. Steam has a lot of things that it still needs to fix, and customer service is one of those biggest ones. The other one is still they have to work on the rating system of how a game is rated and all the review bombings that happen still to this day. They finally implemented ways of knowing if there's other third-party DRMs, but there are other things that Steam needs to work on. But if Epic really wants to compete, if Epic really feels like they're going to be part of this store space, they have to do better than just giving a better cut to publishers. They have to give me, the customer, the consumer, an incentive to use their storefront instead of Steam's. So that means they need to be on par or better than what Steam is providing as the market leader. You can't compete just by locking away content behind your store. See, I am someone that wants to say, okay, I want to go to the place that has the best price for me, has the best support for me, and has everything that I need to enjoy my experience as a gamer. If all Epic Games has is that they're locking up a game in their storefront for a year or 8 months, that's not enough for me to go shop at that store. That's enough for me to not want to shop at that store. So you know what? Let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Will you go be buying games on Epic Games Store, or are you going to wait for the game to come on Steam? What does Epic need to do for them to actually have you go and spend your hard-earned money on their storefront? And if anything, let me know what you think about the video in the comment section down below. Check me out on the Press Start podcast every Thursday at 8:30 Eastern on Press Start Kofi's channel. If you want to support the podcast or myself on Patreon, that is available for you as well. And always check me out on Twitter. Streams will resume once the little man is actually able to sleep through the night, so we'll finish Metal Gear when that happens. But anything and everyone, thank you so much for watching and enjoying and listening, and I really appreciate everything. So hope you have a great day, a great night, and I'll see you guys next time. Have a good one.